back at near the goal line. And here we go from South Bend. A driving low kick that is fielded by Carlisle about the one. Across the 25 and 30, and a good return for Carlisle, brought down by the kicker, but not before he gets all the way up to the 37-yard line. How emotional this moment is for him, Mike.
Yeah, get him going quickly. Move the pocket. Get him comfortable early.
Flanked by Kel McDaniel, and he'll go to the air early. On the far side, it is complete to Will Fuller. And Fuller really doesn't get much of the game, if any. Part have gone on to the NFL. And this is the give to Cam McDaniel, who will be a part of the rotating running backs that run
and Bryant that people are excited to see.
So Golson faced with his first third and long. And they give it to McDaniel, and he is going nowhere. In fact, first punt of the season for Kyle Brinza, the do-it-all kicker for Notre Dame. Kicks off, kicks field goals, and is an excellent punter as well. Bryce Callahan calling for the fair catch just outside the 25-yard line, and that is Jawan Davis is the running back behind Dreyfus Jackson. Very quick and elusive, and they fake to him. Jackson wheels to his left, and his first pass is complete. It's opening series just underway here in South Bend. And Jawan Davis gets the carry again.
And this is where Jordan Taylor, their all-conference wide receiver, usually comes into play, but he's missing today with a foot injury. It's a big loss for Rice.
Play clock down to three. And they get it, and going nowhere is Derek Dillard. Joe Schmidt, transfer from Florida, who always wanted to be a punt returner there, is going to get his shot here in his first game with Notre Dame. He's driven back inside of his own 20, and here comes Wiggs, who's going to be a big part of that defense. Grass. Tarion Folston is in the backfield now as Notre Dame begins this next series, and Folston takes it around the left side, looking for some blocks, close to midfield, and a decent gain for Folston of six on his first carry of the year.
You don't. You have that feel, and I think Folston's one of those guys.
And Golson almost wrapped up, but that's what he does best. He is elusive, and he's able to throw it away. And it's a little bit in the early season workouts, but faced with another third and four here at midfield. Nothing going right. Tries to run it out, and that'll bring up fourth down as the Irish look to pin Rice back deep. High hanging punt by Brinza. Lands at the one, and they just can't get it down deep in Rice territory. Baseball around the athletic circles, but Rice football team doing all they can to change that perception. So Rice in another series here at the 20. And stopped right at the line of scrimmage is Jawan Davis.
235-pound loss means more than people think.
Second and 10. Jackson with time, incomplete. In the final scrimmage of camp.
Yeah, and Sella was the guy that could kind of be in line. He could be an H-back or a fullback. He was an important part of their offense, Dan.
So Jackson faced with his own third and long.
Showing pressure.
And a hold and a give to Dillard. And Dillard is short of the first down over
this year on the defensive side of the ball.
So another punt for James Ferriman, and another chance for special teams, which have not been the highlight of Notre Dame teams in recent years. And Cody Riggs, who had a great return just a few moments ago, with another one into Rice territory at the 47.
And John's
eighth season, and his defense plays with its worst field position of the game as Notre Dame sets up at the 47. And this is Greg Bryant. And Bryant flashing some of that talent.
Explosion. Sticks his foot to the ground, and it's special.
Second down and five. Golson comes out of it, gets to the 40 and no further. For this is more the type of offense that Brian Kelly has yearned to run. on third and three. Play action. Nice touch pass to Golson. And for the first down, it's Ben Koyak, the big tight end, brought down by Julius White. So first and 10. And this is once again Greg Bryant for another good game. Now inside the Owl 20 at the 19, second and 3. And on the right side, looking for the first down marker, is Greg Bryant, who picks it up. Bryant right up the middle. And gets it down close to the 11-yard line.
You know, red zone offense. Touchdown, hit rate.
Golson, looked like another design play. Comes out of it on second and 7 and goes in for the touchdown. So it's Golson, who hasn't played in more than a year and a half, who scores the first touchdown of the 2014 season on an 11-yard touchdown run.
Yeah, this is definitely a predetermined run. Watch the pass set by the left tackle, Stanley. He'll get just enough of a piece and force that defensive end outside. Golson does a heck of a job following Greg Bryant through the hole. Touchdown.
So Kyle Brinza, who has now made 56 straight PATs dating back to 2012. So accurate. Tacks on the extra point. And Notre Dame, with just more than 6 minutes left in the opening quarter of the opening game, gets a touchdown from Everett Golson to take a 7-0 lead. Notre Dame has had a history, Mike. We talked about it coming in, of kind of slow starts and openers at home.
Yeah, to Brian Kelly, they lost to South Florida, played two poor games that they won against Purdue, and another so-so effort last year against him.
So Brinza puts it in play. Mario Hall watches it bounce in front of him.
That's a bad break.
It just curls out.
Involved, he was trying to with some zone reads early, but he said, the heck with it, we're running quarterback draw, naked bootleg into it, got a little rhythm going, and then as Mike and I talked about last night, red zone efficiency.
Bryant was the difference in that last drive.
Yeah, definitely accented it with Bryant slicing through there and running. He's going to be very explosive all year long.
So on second and 9, Drakus Jackson's going to keep it and pull his way up close to the 40. That'll still bring up third and long.
Need some success for confidence.
See the line there, brought to you by the UPS store. On third down and 5 from the 39, Jackson sets up and the pass complete and wide open with all sorts of room over the middle, all the way up close to the 30-yard line. And the Owls in a fast pace here. And Bryant. Play fake. Jackson hangs in there. Buys more time and down the far sideline. A nice one hauled in there.
Nice catch by Pollard.
So the ball inside the 20. Rice with a good opportunity here with 3:20 left in the opening quarter, trailing 7-0. Jawan Davis twists his way down close to the 15. His captain, who is injured in practice on Thursday. Second down and 7. Ball outside the 15. Play action. Jackson wheels to his right. Going to run it close to the first down marker.
Yeah, that was an easy one, Dan. The right tackle holding. Holding.
Offense. Number 75. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Second down.
It's like he's showing three-man rush.
Jackson wide open at the 5-yard line is Zach Wright for the touchdown. So they get in the big hole and bam, they come to Wright for 26 yards.
North has become a story already.
Hairston, the new kicker for Rice, adds the extra point. Ben for the Notre Dame Fighting Irish, opening up with the Rice Owls, who just scored to make it 7-7. Hopefully the weather forecast that was pretty much gloom and doom earlier will get through this, because there are some bands of weather, but again, not expected a little bit later on.
So, yeah, you talked a little bit early about Kamari Russell out. Austin Collins were out, and the ramifications were on that play.
Big hit. Hairston puts it through, so it'll come out to the 25 in 1915. Two of the last three meetings, Notre Dame went on to win the national title in 73 and 78 after victories. Golson going deep for the first time, and wide open as well. Souza with a point after makes it 14-7.
Both ways. Notre Dame took advantage. You're going to see this time right down here and to the post. Julius White can't stay with him. Because of the play-action fake, great protection, he gets Julius White turned, and trust me, I saw this kid play in high school, Will Fuller. He's as fast as any wide receiver in college football. A year ago, 6 receptions for 160 yards. And he continues his big play. And one of the questions I had, Dan, heading into this season is who's going to step up at wide receiver for the Irish? How about a demonstrative play by Will Fuller?
In our conversation with Golson yesterday, he mentioned immediately Will Fuller looking for big things out of him. He's a deep threat.
Yep.
One play, 12 seconds, 75 yards, and it's 14-7. And brings his big leg, hits the back of the end zone. And the Owls will come out to the 25 for their, having won 15 of their last 19 dating back to the 2012 season. Coach Bailiff said it was important they didn't get in a hole early. They're down just 14-7, and the goal is to go on Davis. Yeah. And good pursuit by Notre Dame, led by Jalen Smith. A low that it comes at Notre Dame Stadium. Trailing by 7. Steps up and fires incomplete.
Worth getting everybody lined up and making all the checks.
So 3rd and 11. Jackson dumps it over the middle. And it's a good gain close to the 30 by Derek Dillard, but he's still well short of the first down. Gain of 6. And we've got Greg Bryant now back deep after Cody Riggs returned a couple for 24 and 25 yards. They're going to put Greg Bryant back there to receive the punt, and it is a low driving punt. Takes a huge hop over Bryant's head and rolls all the way down to the 3. Bryant picks it up and salvages this out of it. All in all, pretty good game out to about the 12 or 13 yard line for captains elected late in camp for Notre Dame. And this pass complete to Koyak. Related activities. So it has been a swirling offseason for the Notre Dame football program, but there is the one steady influence, Cam McDaniel.
Dark versatile.
He also had an active offseason. Got married. He's an expected father as well. Golson to the air over the middle, and that is complete to Corey Robinson, who makes his first catch of 2014.
Middle of the field safely and comfortably. Well done.
And the Irish hurry it up all the way at the 30-yard line. This is Golson brought down. You saw Corey Robinson. Oh, and a missed tackle behind the line of scrimmage as McDaniel is able to shake it off.
Tackle number 1 for Rice.
Golson over to his right, and he throws it right into the hands of Gabe Baker, who, had he held on, got a lot of green in front of him. Carter coming off another incredible year. 20 of 26, and this one, though, is well off the mark. Activities around campus earlier on, but there is definitely some gray skies and some activity out there. In fact, they just made an announcement on the PA system here to the crowd in case of bad weather. Maybe ready for head to safety, but we'll see. That is Juwan Davis on the first play of this drive. It was expected. It's just a matter of how these thunderstorms lined up and if there would be any electricity, because the field, you know, is going to be fine with this new turf. Dreyfus Jackson with a beauty across the side there to Dennis Parks.
Illegal formation against the offense. 5 men in the backfield. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
So if he's not 100%, they just didn't want to risk it. He is that important to the team for the remainder of the season. So second down and 12 after that one is brought back, and the snap is low. Jackson able to scoop it up on the hop, and incomplete, wanting Dennis Parks, who got a hand after the poor Gator season last year and thought it might be better to play one more year, get into the business school here at Notre Dame, and try to lead the Irish secondary. Third down and 12, another flag comes in the backfield.
You know, prior to the snap, delay a game. Offense number 6. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
The program. So on 3rd and long, 17 The Owls backed up at their own 15. Jackson comes out of the pocket and gets it up to the 25-yard line. Still well short of the first down before Matthias Farley brings him down after a gain of 10. Is back deep to receive the punt again for Notre Dame. As Fairman angles this one to the right, and here comes Bryant.
Special teams different this year, Dan.
Under gray skies with 11:22 left in the opening half. Notre Dame setting up at the Rice Owl 49. And weather getting closer, we understand. Nelson comes out again. Skirts to the outside, just not able to stay on.
What he does, that's when Golson's most effective.
Second down and 3. And flags come in as the Rice defense can cross.
Snap infraction. Number 72. Offense. Yep. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Yes, sir. Now to San Diego. Both of them are outstanding. And the reason why is Harry Eastand, their offensive line coach here at Notre Dame.
Well, second and 8. Golson feels the pressure, and this time he is sacked back at the 45 by Zach Pat, the 49.
Let's draw screen here. Some kind of quarterback run also.
There he goes. Hang in the pocket a little bit. Looks and goes deep down the field. Wide open. And not able to hang on as CJ.
That is a beautiful job by the young quarterback.
So what would have been a 55-yard touchdown catch by Procise, instead they punt it and turn the ball back over to Rice. FedEx Cup playoffs on a Labor Day weekend. Dan Hicks, Mike Mayock, Catherine Tappan, Doug Flutie here with you for the Notre Dame opener, and Dreyfus Jackson showing a little bit of that mobility as the Rice quarterback moves it out for a first down at a gain of 19.
Cutting off the inside pursuit.
We were hearing that his father made the trip out here from Saudi Arabia to see his son play. Dan playing on the national championship team, and that one is dropped by Mario Hull. Going to be wearing Owl garb, but not Notre Dame in support of the son. And what father wouldn't do that?
It's all about the blood, right? I mean, blood first, alma mater second.
Dad works in Saudi Arabia, making a long trip to see his son play.
Nice and Rice here.
Rice Owls, a 3-touchdown underdog, staying right in this game at 14-7. Jackson comes out of the pocket and gets the first down into Irish territory at the 47. So a big 3rd and 8 conversion for Dreyfus. Jack plays a number of positions for Rice on offense. Number 35.
Oh, there it is. Touchdown.
From the shotgun, wide open, and there is Luke Turner. Complete all the way down to the 20. Didn't get in, Mike, but got 25.
Bubble screens in a row. Now 35 here. Turner's going to fake that he blocks and then release up the field. Cole Luke and the safety both beat on that. That's Shoemate. One of the two has deep responsibility. Another bust by the Irish team.
And Rice in the hurry up. Jackson slides in. Line him up in the Wildcat, which they call the Wild Owl at times. Haven't seen it yet. But there's Jawan Davis.
You know what I like? I
love everyone calls him. And when we say everyone, his parents call him Bob. His 35 from the Irish 16.
There's Luke Turner. Watch him run in a wheel route. Got to get him involved.
Jackson does another good job of avoiding some defenders, and he will be wrestled out there by Jalen Smith, so that'll bring up 4th down.
That kid's a potential All-American. He's really gifted, and he's taken his game up another notch.
And there is James Hairston. This is the very first field goal attempt of his college career, and it is good in 2012 at the BCS National Championship game. Instead of driving it, kind of served a dual role there to kind of say, hey, Everett, you know, that was a different kind of team. It was great, but this is your team. This is Amir Carlisle kind of spinning around.
Take off and run, and then you calm down, especially in a situation where Everett hadn't played in so long.
This is Greg Bryant. Greg Bryant taking the pile all the way for first down yardage. More than 5 minutes left in the opening half. Notre Dame 14, Rice 10. And after the Bryant run, Golson hanging in the pocket and throwing it up top, and that ball is complete. All in the fourth quarter against Purdue, and just had 17 carries for the rest of the season. But now he's in that slot wide receiver role as Golson heads out to Chris Brown. And Brown for more good yardage inside the 30 for another first down and a gain of 14.
Boy,
Notre Dame on the move here.
Nice cut.
So is Bryant. That was really quick. Goes Notre Dame down to the Rice 16. With another first and 10. And a quick hit to the outside to Fuller, who had the big touchdown earlier. And this time, they corral him for not much of the gain, Zach Pat. For a guy that hasn't been in the heat of competition for such a long time.
He's made one bad throw, the rest of the half been false.
Now second and 8. Just winging it out of bounds. Well, that's the side of the stadium we're on. Sun splashed, including the field, and then you look across.
And 8
from the Owl, 14. Golson flanked by McDaniel to his left.
He's changing the play because there's three defense backs over the two wideouts.
Golson stepping up, going to come out and run. It's going to get the first down and leap into the end zone for the touchdown. That's the Golson everybody got to know real well back in 2012. Play breaks down, turn on the Jets, and turn it into a score. He led Notre Dame in rushing touchdowns back in 2012 at Orchard Point, 21-10.
Two things. Watch his patience, and then watch Connor Hanratty, 65, get a bump on the nose tackle, which opens it up, and now all this is innate athletic ability. He extends the football. His eyes are up and downfield. Little pump fake. Doug Flutie, what do you see? I'm enjoying this, man.
Oh, yeah, no doubt about it. Everett saw three-man rush, and he's so predictable. It's third down. Look at him fly. It's third down. Unless somebody is wide open, I'm hanging on to the ball, and I'm going to make a play with my feet.
Yeah, I think we're seeing the birth of a dynamic quarterback, somebody that people are going to be talking about around the
house. Has been a huge influence on Notre Dame, spreading it back out to a 21-10 margin.
About 8 for 12 for 169 and 2 rushing touchdowns. One bad throw all day. The rest has been impeccable.
Big leg of Brinza sends it almost into the stadium crowd. Report. 2:33 left in the opening half. Dreyfus, Jackson, and Rice begin at the 25. And Jackson with a toss out to Juwan Davis with a good run.
He's in print felt.
Second down and 5. Here's Davis again. Short of the first down, I believe.
Cross one off your bucket list at age 20. I like that.
Third and short for Rice. Coming up with a minute and a half mark in the opening half. Jackson quickly turns and gives to Derek Dillard, who picks up the first down. Oh. Jackson over the middle. That pass is complete. Dennis Parks. But good pursuit by Notre Dame. Second down and 5. And that is complete to Luke Turner, or is it Bob?
No, he's Bob.
Two different stints, and said he never had that victim mentality. He just wanted to go to work. And boy, did they ever go to work. Here's Jackson trying to avoid the pressure, but down he goes. Matthias Farley in the backfield there.
And now for Rice, you're looking for at least field goal opportunity. Your kicker's got a big leg.
Even though he's just got one career kick, but he does have a strong leg. Jackson trying to give him some more, but he is intercepted by Farley, who's had quite a series.
Just a bad play by an inexperienced quarterback. He does a great job buying time, but I have no idea why he would throw this football. Dreyfus Jackson in the pocket. Slides, moves, eyes down the field. So far, pretty good, but why this ball's thrown, I have no idea. Matthias Farley, nice job. Ball comes right to you. Make the catch. That's a bad decision and a bad throw.
It's the first turnover of the day, and it goes Notre Dame's way.
Olsen dance around, buy time, use his legs. This is where you get that X factor.
Irish do have one timeout. Olsen's going to try to get a big chunk right here. Just out of the outstretched arm. He's a Fuller who is streaking down the sideline. So second down and 10. Clock winds again. Olsen avoids the pressure. He's going to go long, deep downfield again, and looking at the goal line for the touchdown is Procise. Procise dropped one earlier that would have been a 55-yarder. He hangs on for a 53-yard score.
Can justify letting a guy get behind you in this situation. I don't get that one.
And it really stings even more. Here's another look at Golson from behind.
Again, this is college football today. Slides to his left, eyes down the field, sees Procise deep. Easy touchdown, and again, I don't understand how a guy can get this open. I see the trip there in the man coverage. That was Gabe Baker, their captain, who tripped. None of the safeties stayed home. You can't allow that to happen in the last minute of a half. That's cardinal sin on defense, but let's face it, every Golson's pretty special.
He's on the ground. He's thrown for 222 yards. And we've got another second half to go. 5 seconds remain. It's now with an 18-point lead.
And now Brian Van Gorder can tee off selectively.
Dreyfus Jackson will take a knee, and that will be it. So it was the Everett Golson show down the stretch, which has given Notre Dame a 28-10 lead in the fifth meeting ever between the two schools. Home opener for Notre Dame, season opener for both. And the weather so far, good news, it has stayed away. It was an ominous forecast ever since earlier in the week, but so far, so good. And hopefully we continue to be uninterrupted as the Rice Owls will have the first chance with the football to begin this second half. And a look at the stats. Notre Dame dominating in total yards. And the one turnover committed by Rice.
Understand that Everett Golson was responsible for 250 of those 333 yards and all four touchdowns.
So Kyle Brinza to kick it off. Rice hasn't had a chance, and they won't here either. That'll come out to the 25 as they beat a ranked opponent on the road. So down by 18, that's the obstacle they face here as they begin at the 25.
I'm not sure how you do that.
As the play clock with
delay a game. Offense, number 6, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Jackson again in his second career start.
A lot of question marks in that Notre Dame secondary. They look confused again.
And this is Jawan Davis getting loose a bit.
Austin Collinsworth not playing.
That's Notre Dame now without 5 players being held. He's going to play football. A couple of years ago, sat out that entire run to the BCS championship game with 2 surgeries in his back and shoulder, and then he's poised to end off his eligibility here, and he's hurt watching from the sidelines. This is Derek Dillard. Started this drive. Fake by Jackson. Hangs in the pocket, feels the pressure, and down he goes at the 39. His very first game here at Notre Dame. On 2nd and 14. Jackson chased out a bit. Pass is complete at midfield to Pollard. And Pollard picks up a big game, picks up the first down. Pollard all of last year, 4 carries, as he's now into the receiving portion of Rice big time. Brandon Hamilton with his first action here.
Man at my side, Our Lady on the Dome looking down, and the roar of your cheers at our backs. We cannot lose.
2nd and 6. Another first down. So now a pounding rain all of a sudden, and a 1st and 10 for Rice. And it is really coming down. Set up at the Irish 34. Davis moves the pile for a good game. Here for any kind of evacuation, any kind of electricity in the air. Second down and four. Here's Davis again. This time Notre Dame's defense is there to meet him for maybe a little bit of a loss. Reyes lightened up a little bit. Play clock getting down to the final few seconds, and Jackson this time just gets it off in time. Third and four, down the sideline, incomplete. And James Hairston to attempt his second career college field goal try, and that one is blocked. That was an attempt. James sets up now just inside its own 30, and Golson gives it to Tarion Folston, who had just one carry, I believe, 170 yards as a freshman running back last year. Olson just kind of floats in and out. Now he floats to the sideline and throws it out of bounds. The best player for Rice on either side of the ball. Third down and seven, but has remained for the most part in check by the Irish offensive line. Golson buying a little more time, darts back in the pocket. Now comes out to the sideline looking for the first down marker. And he got it. Words that he told us yesterday coming true. He said the quarterback in Golson will dictate everything. Golston doing a dance of his own.
That's what I was talking about a minute ago.
Captain and Folston and Bryant learning below him. This is Fuller, who had the big score earlier in the first half.
Make a play on defense.
Second down, called a two. There's one. Now it's third down and a lot longer than that, maybe six.
But I really like that.
Well, they mark it at the 42, so third down and four. Golson looking to convert again, and he does. About midway through this third quarter.
Corey Robinson's one-on-one.
Golson going deep. Robinson was there. Double coverage out there. Never had a chance at it. Second down and 10. Just a light misting rain after the downpour earlier. And this is the team captain McDaniel plowing up ahead for the first down. Golson on first and 10. Out to McDaniel. Avoiding some defenders and then just lowering the head. Down to the 15-yard line. Second down and three. Fouls come vaulting across the line as flags come in.
Part of the snap. Snap infraction. Number 72.
That's twice.
Offense.
Yeah.
5-yard penalty. Still second down.
The games of the season, but back and voted team captain by his teammates. But a couple of miscues there. Backs it up on second and eight, and they go to McDaniel. The Stanley right tackle all last year, moving over into that big spot. McDaniel is met with force by Zach Pat.
Notre Dame special team, but they really need this guy to be consistent. Historically, he's been better from 50 than he's been between 30 and 39.
Yeah, he had three 50-plus field goals that he made last year. This one from 35, and he gets that one inside the upright. Think of that.
I think I'd take that over all kinds of other youthful endeavors.
Notre Dame has scored 17 unanswered points. The Irish up 31-10, 4:07 left in the third. And here it is, the Wild Owl formation for Rice. Luke Turner, number 35, who we mentioned is very familiar with it, does a number of things out of it, and doesn't really get off the ground in Wild Owl play number one. And lost a yard, so it's Wild Owl one and out as Dreyfus Jackson is back in. Right over the middle, and his pass is in and out of the arms of Robbie Wells with four former high school quarterbacks.
Not since Joe Paterno back in like the 70s.
That's crazy, but the philosophy being that if they're a high school quarterback, we can figure out some place for them to play. Third and 11, Jackson scrambling, brought down short of the first down. Better start to special teams, and fake. They were in punt formation, and it's the fake.
It's Bob.
And it's Bob Luke Turner, who is short. I believe
Anawalu
to get to the 35, and it's no, he's short.
Him up and making the initial contact. Direct snap to 35. Bob takes it up. That looks good right there. There's the initial hit. All his buddies come in, but that's Anawalu squaring up the hit and making the tackle, because it looked good right here.
Yeah, he just needed to just bounce off, but they wrestle into the ground, and the words of Van Gorder, the defense progression from wide receiver to hits like that. And Notre Dame takes over on downs just inside the Rice 35. Up 31-10, trying to add to it, and Koyak can't hang on.
Big tight end, but you can't drop that.
Mentioned earlier, Troy Nicholas going pro is opening the door for Koyak. This is Golson dancing his way out to the sideline.
Impressive is him when he's running around and there's nothing there to get rid of the ball and live to fight another down.
Is this the Golson you remember from two seasons ago?
Connects to him for 22 yards, and now it's first and 10 just outside the 10 at the 11 of Rice.
Nice to see Carlisle make a play. They've been waiting for that.
Here's Bryant right up the middle, pounding his way down close to the first down. They can get the first down just inside the one. Down inside a minute left here in the third. Notre Dame with already 17 unanswered points, looking to add more. Golson's already been in twice on the ground. So the ball at the four, they can pick up the first. The fake to Bryant. Now Golson looking for a hole, inching his way in across for his third touchdown of the game. Worked out. Ooh, Rinza just gets that in. Turns for Notre Dame. Three on the ground, a couple of long strikes. And with 17 seconds left in the third, and Notre Dame.
Texas A&M.
And how impressive was Texas A&M in the opener over South Carolina, Steve Spurrier the other night.
Johnny Football number two.
Kenny Football.
Yeah,
calling him. This is Jackson with a nice run for a first down. As we head to the fourth, it was close all the way into the second quarter when it was 14-10, but 24 unanswered points later. Notre Dame up 38-10 in the opener for both teams of the 2014 season as we start the fourth with Rice and Juwan Davis, who is met there. Schmidt, the former walk-on in the starting role, really put a hit on him. Jackson bounces off the pads of Darian Pollard.
Mistake at the end of the first half, and it adds up to 38-10.
There's the UPS store on third and 10. And Jackson's got more pressure, able to get rid of it. And tightroping his way down the sidelines is Dillard.
Side, couple missed tackles. Van Gorder doesn't like that one at all.
Rice now up at the 48. Right up the middle again is Dillard, his in order to catch up to your big brother.
Good luck with that one.
But he was a prolific
great player.
Receiver for Rice. Second down and six, and this one skips in incomplete to Davis. I mean, you didn't expect it to be maybe 38-10. Maybe you expected a little bit more efficiency from the Rice offense, Mike.
I think you're looking at a group of four and five star recruits on one side of the line of scrimmage and two and three star on the other. So Notre Dame's got an advantage.
Jackson.
Oh, another draw.
Unable to connect to a streaking Zach Wright.
Assignments on Thursday practice. So this heavy blitz scheme cuts both ways. You make more big plays, but you're more susceptible on the back end.
This is Greg Bryant. Good back.
You might want a fair catch on Gregory.
Yep. Very tough schedule. Six opponents had double-digit wins last season. Five of them ranked in the preseason as Tyrion Folston gets the carry here to start the after the Folston gain.
Good cut.
Folston just out there for a walk in the park down to the 40.
Appalachian State, who had a big day.
Bolston's worked his way up to 44 yards and more. Well, not much around the left side.
That guy right there, he stands, going to develop this next group. I think they're going to be just as good by the end of the season.
Second down and six. Popping it across midfield after the second effort as Folston picks up another first down, gain of 10.
It's just an outstanding combination block by the center and left guard.
Hanratty, the son of Dad Terry, the quarterback. and part of the Notre Dame National Championship team all those years ago. Golson showing some touch to Ben Koyak, the tight end, for another first down. Not much there for Polston. Down to the 15. Koyak. And on second and 7, Polston. Short of the first down. That'll bring up third down. Just about at the 12-yard line.
Probably the best pass protection guy. Catches the ball well. So it'll be different players for different situations.
Third down and 4. Golson wanted to get out of there in a hurry. And in the pinstripe bowl with a victory over Rutgers. Again, missing from 39 earlier. This is a 29-yarder for Brinza to make it 41-10. No problem. Conversation about that, Mike, before it was installed, after it was installed summer, but they had to resurface this field some 3 times last season, and Brian Kelly was excited to get on this turf. Enables the team to hold as many practices as they want, pretty much, regardless of starting quarterbacks, because Tyler Stelling, number 10, is in taking the snap here for Rice as they begin at the 25. He hands off to Jawan Davis.
Practice earlier this week, much more accomplished passer, had a big scrimmage 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, known as a pretty good thrower, not as mobile as Jackson. He hands off to Jawan Davis. Not
work the next quarterback in, get him, give him a taste. You've got an open week next week, you're getting ready for Texas A&M. Get a taste for your second quarterback so he can feel it.
Davis picks up the first down on third and short. And this is Brandon Hamilton across the 40.
Bills, you know, before you head into conference play, and they're going to be competitive in conference play, trust me.
This is Brandon Hamilton again. First down and 10. For Tyler Stelling in his first series of the game in relief of Dreyfus Jackson. And a big 6'5" Stelling steps in over the top, and just like that, James Maiden with a score. For James, as Hairston comes on to tack on the extra point, Rice makes it a little closer. 41-17, under 5 left. It is the next chapter of Notre Dame's football legacy. New year, new field, new uniforms, and like every year, a new team and the freshmen joining this year, a part of the legacy. Notre Dame Reborn coming your way next Saturday at 1:30 on NBC. What are your thoughts on the new turf field, Mike?
I'm a traditionalist, and I love a grass field whenever you can have it. However, the field had gotten so embarrassing, and I'd say alert hands team, by the way, watch you onside, but I just feel like their field had gotten so embarrassing for a big-time program, it had to happen. Plus, I think there's more consistent surface, and I think Brian Kelly and the kind of athlete he's recruiting dictates that they need that.
Yeah, they had to resurface the field 3 times last year, and any hand right now with under 5 minutes left, 41-17. And here he is, Malik Zaire.
He high-stepped it.
Waited a lot longer than a lot of people thought to finally announce that Golson was his guy, but Zaire, very competitive. And
year not play at all, then lose a quarterback competition. Mm-hmm. I know Doug Flutie went to Boston College, and he was an afterthought. I mean, look at this.
Oh, Ryan up the middle, and he's got the score, loses the ball, but he's in.
Another really good cut by Bryant. You can see that explosion that Tony Alford was talking about. Gets up into the hole, explodes through 2 would-be tacklers, cuts back across the green, makes the safety mix, miss.
First touchdown in a Notre Dame Fighting Irish uniform. Brinza adds the extra point. 40
quarterback to stay into the mix, stay ready, prepare, and be ready to go in a moment's notice.
You know, Doug, I get a little frustrated sometimes with that. I think it's tough for any position, any player. when you were Boston College as a freshman, you were
familiar with how Doug Flutie became the starter that he became. We don't have enough time to possibly delve into it. It is an incredible story how Flutie was ready, took advantage of the time that when he had his shot.
No. It's all about me hosting.
Offense,
number 51, 5-yard penalty.
It was all.
Or maybe an Ivy League school. And then a fifth-year senior takes me around. He, you know, he was ruining his day.
You know what?
I didn't care the name of the building anyway.
It's the first time you told me that.
The rest is history.
Yeah, one Heisman,
one Heisman later, and an incredible NFL career as well into his 40s. And here he is.
And that snap could come next week at Michigan in a tie game in the fourth quarter. You don't have any control over anything except being ready.
And that was the beauty of the 2012 season for Kelly. I know it was a different kind of quarterback situation as Rice fumbles the football and Notre Dame is able to recover. That is Nicky Baratti, who missed all last year with a shoulder, who brings a smile from Brian Van Gorder on the turnover.
Yeah, the key there was the tackle by sophomore Devin Butler. Strips it right there, number 12. Baratti alertly sees it. It's on the football. There's the strip. Free ball. Nicky Baratti gets it.
Baratti, one of 11 Notre Dame players from the state of Texas, and Brian Van Gorder, who we saw so frustrated earlier in the game, that is light years away from the expression we saw earlier on Van Gorder's face. Again, two new coordinators for Brian Kelly. And that was another one of the big question marks coming into this game. And yes, Notre Dame was a 3-touchdown favorite over Rice in an official game. And now we can just totally focus on Michigan.
They have to play 5 ACC games a year. The Big Ten now has to play 9 in-conference games each year. The combination of the two makes it harder to keep all your traditional rivals.
So that is going to do it. And Brian Kelly goes to 1-0. And Rice 0-1, having lost all 5 meetings in the history of this series with the Fighting Irish. So it will be Notre Dame and Michigan both at 1-0 under the lights here.